Next, we are going to see how you express likes and dislikes. How you ask a person for what he likes or what she likes, and how they show their preferences. Okay, shall we see that now? I'm going to give you a dialogue between one person, Srinath, and the headmaster, and how they come out with their preferences. Okay, I'll just write down the dialogue and we can check how they show their preferences. For example, you go out for dinner, and you go and sit at a restaurant, and your friend is treating you for the dinner. Immediately as you go, he will not be ordering anything, isn't it? He will ask you, Suresh, would you like to have Chinese cuisine, or would you like North Indian cuisine? Cuisine means the variety of food. And you may say, I like Chinese food. So Chinese food is noodles, fried rice, and all the varieties, okay, chicken fried rice and all that. If you say North Indian food, it's thali meal, it may be roti, naan, like that. So when somebody asks you for your preference, you give your choice. Okay, same way you go out for a cup of coffee, you go to a snack bar, and there they may ask you, hey, would you like coffee or tea? You say, I would like tea. Or you may say, I would like coffee with less sugar, or I would like tea without milk. So you are expressing your preferences. Okay, so let's do this dialogue, and then we'll see how people can express their wishes. Srinath. Good morning, sir. Instead of headmaster, you can even put the officer or manager, okay? Good morning, Srinath. And you have Prabhu also there. Prabhu's also with the headmaster, and say, hello, Srinath. How are you? Hello, Prabhu. How are you? Now the headmaster says, I'm glad you both come on time. You both come on time. For which Srinath says, it's very kind of you to have invited us. So the headmaster has invited Srinath and Prabhu somewhere, and let's see what they are going to do. And master says, it's a pleasure. My wife suggested that we ask you both, or that we ask you both means invite you, it means. Okay. Ask you both over for tea. Then immediately Prabhu says, we too have been waiting to visit you. Then headmaster says, well, shall we start? Shall we start with some slices of cake? For which I would love to. Srinath says, and Prabhu says, they are delicious, delicious. They are delicious. Then the headmaster asks, would you like coffee or tea? And he says, Prabhu says, I'd like tea. And Srinath also says, even I shall have tea. Okay, now I'm just cutting short the dialogue, because we can proceed the dialogue with lot of things what headmaster is giving to Srinath and Prabhu, but we'll stop with this. Okay, now let's see. Srinath, good morning sir. Headmaster, good morning Srinath. Prabhu, hello Srinath. So Prabhu is already there with the headmaster. So they are all in headmaster's house. Srinath, hello Prabhu, how are you? Headmaster, I'm glad you've both come on time. Srinath, it's very kind of you to have invited us. Headmaster, it's a pleasure. My wife suggested that we ask you both for tea. Tea in the sense here, it means for some snacks and tea. Tea doesn't mean only tea, okay? That is evening time snacks. Prabhu, we too have been waiting to visit you. Headmaster, well, shall we start with some slices of, cake? Srinath, I would love to. And Prabhu already tastes one piece of cake and he says they are delicious. Delicious means very tasty. Headmaster, would you like coffee or tea? Prabhu says, I'd like tea. And Srinath says, even I shall have tea. Okay, so goes on the conversation. So what do you find in this conversation? First, the headmaster invites and then he asks for preferences, his likes and dislikes. Would you like to have this? Would you like to have, would you like to start with some cake? Would you like coffee or tea? And you saw how Srinath and Prabhu express their likes and dislikes and how they appreciated what food was given to them. So you should always learn to appreciate when somebody throws out a party. You should be thankful and you should always say good things about what you have just had. And also you can, when they ask you for preferences, you can openly tell them. Okay, so this is how you maintain a conversation. Okay, what we are going to do now is, I'm going to give you another short exercise. I'm going to give three different dialogues where certain words, the verb is within brackets and you should put the right verb there to make the sentence more meaningful. Okay, see, asking for preferences need not be only for food. It can even be for reading books, your taste of novels, your taste of movies, your preferences in colors, dresses, anything. Okay, so let's do it now. Let's assume A and B. Okay. Do you dash want or enjoy? Reading English novels? And what does B say? Yes, I like or want to read English novels. But I prefer Tamil fiction. Okay, you like something, but you prefer something else also. Now A, who do you love or like B replies, I like talking to children. Okay, the next conversation, I'll first write and then we can work it out. A. Do you ever bake? Yes, my mother taught me to bake. What do you bake? You bake cookies, you bake cakes. Okay? Then A asks again. Can or wood? You bake a cake sometime? And B says, I would. Want or love? Okay, we have two dialogues here between A and B, and here also A and B. Now, do you want or enjoy reading English novels? What word will you put in there? Do you enjoy? Do you enjoy reading English novels? Reading English novels, then here the B says, yes, I like to read, not want to read, I like to read English novels, but I prefer Tamil fiction. What is fiction? Fiction is a story that is not true. It cannot be realistic. It can be fictitious, it can be imaginary and all that. Okay, that's what fiction is. Who do you like or love talking to you, talking to? Who do you love or like talking to? Now, you have the clue in the next line. I like talking to. So, who do you like talking to? I like talking to children. Okay, so you know how to fill in the right verb for your dialogue. Next one. Do you ever bake? Asks A to B. And B says, yes, my mother taught me to bake. Can or would you bake a cake for me? If she had asked, can you bake a cake for me? It is like whether he or she is able to, that is the ability. But would you bake a cake for me will be, it's a request, okay? Would you bake a cake for me? I would love to. Okay? Would you becomes a very polite request. So, we'll read it again. Do you ever bake? Yes, my mother taught, one minute, I'll fill it up. Do you ever bake? Yes, my mother taught me to bake. Would you bake a cake for me? I would love to. Okay, so this is how you carry on a conversation, and here they are showing preferences and also their likes and dislikes. So, with this we can also put in imaginary roles and we can try it out. So when you talk to a third person or another person, you can express your desires, you can express your preferences, but don't ever forget to be polite. Okay? If you don't say, can you bake a cake for me, it will be too very rude. And also grammatically, would will be better. Okay? Would you bake a cake for me? That's a polite request.